2 weeks ago, Boston College looked like one of the worst teams in the ACC, and maybe even the Power Five. The Eagles were averaging 16.3 points per game, and under 10 in conference play. At times, BC's rushing attack was promising, but it was hardly consistent. Through the air, the Eagles were inefficient to say the least. Quarterback Anthony Brown was recording just 4.7 yards per pass attempt and had only completed 3 passes over 30 yards. Then, all of a sudden, everything came together. Against Louisville, BC totaled 555 yards of offense, including 361 in the second half alone, in a 45-42 upset victory. To put that in perspective, head coach Steve Adazio's team had only logged 350-plus yards of offense once all season. The Eagles put on an encore performance this past weekend with a resounding win over Virginia. For the second straight game, BC racked up 40-plus points and over 500 yards of offense. Brown completed close to 80% of his passes, averaged 11.5 yards per pass attempt, and tossed a career-high 3 touchdowns, en route to ACC Rookie of the Week honors. But most importantly, BC came away with another road victory. Earlier this month, people were starting to speculate whether or not the Eagles would win a single conference game this season. Now, there's no telling when they'll lose one. Their recent success just goes to show that you can't count out any team in the ACC. 1. Clemson, 6-1, 4-1 Atlantic Coast, AP poll, number 7. Clemson head coach Dabo Swinney owes the scheduling gods big time. The Tigers got a much-needed week off, following their stunning loss to Syracuse. Not only did the break in play provide Swinney some time to game plan for Georgia Tech, but it also allowed quarterback Kelly Bryant to rest up. The junior tweaked his ankle against Wake Forest and then sustained a concussion at Syracuse. Clemson's offense hinges on the health and mobility of Bryant. If the Tigers want in on this year's national title game, every game is do or die from here on out. 2. Miami, 6-0, 4-0 Atlantic Coast, AP poll, number 8. Once again, Miami needed all 4 quarters to extend what is now its longest winning streak in 15 years. After a 53-yard Cole Murphy field goal brought Syracuse within a point of the Hurricanes, quarterback Malik Rozier went to work. Miami's 9-play, 85-yard drive culminated in a Travis Homer 33-yard touchdown run, which all but sealed the Hurricanes' 11th consecutive win. Rozier surpassed the 300-yard mark for the second time this year and pitched a pair of touchdowns. But the Hurricanes' defense was by far the team's most impressive unit. Miami picked off quarterback Eric Dungy 4 times in the first half and held Steve Ishmael and Irvin Phillips, 2 of the nation's top 4 wideouts, under 100 yards receiving. 3. North Carolina State, 6-1, 4-0 Atlantic Coast, AP poll, number 14. Thanks to a bye week, North Carolina State was able to hang on to its 6-game winning streak, its longest in 15 years, for a few more days. The Wolfpack will fly to South Bend, Indiana this weekend to take on number 9 Notre Dame in what'll be its 3rd game against a ranked opponent this season. On paper, this is a perfect matchup for North Carolina State. The Irish's offense is built on the run game. Notre Dame is averaging about 320 yards on the ground per contest. Luckily for the Wolfpack, it has the 3rd best rushing defense in the nation. A win against the Irish could very well bump North Carolina State up 5 or so spots in the polls. 4. Virginia Tech, 6-1, 2-1 Atlantic Coast, AP poll, number 13. Josh Jackson only completed 10 passes against North Carolina on Saturday, but 3 of them went for touchdowns. That was more than enough, considering the help the redshirt freshman quarterback was getting from his teammates. Virginia Tech's defense scored twice. Ricky Walker scooped up a fumble deep in Tar Heel territory for the first touchdown of the game. Later, Reggie Floyd picked off quarterback Brandon Harris and ran the ball back 69 yards for another score. The special teams unit got in on the scoring party too. Greg Stroman notched his second punt return touchdown of the season, this one good for 91 yards. The Hokies will continue to pad their resume next week when Duke comes to town. 5. Georgia Tech, 4-2-3-1 Atlantic Coast, that's more like it. After rushing for a measly 18 yards on 19 carries last week against Miami, quarterback Taquan Marshall ran all over Wake Forest's defense for 163 yards and a pair of touchdowns, the second of which was a deciding 70-yard triple option, quarterback keeper. The junior's partner in crime, Kervant Benson, got back on track too. He ran for 136 yards and a score, helping GT rally back from 11 points down in the first half. The Yellow Jackets' top 25 defense shined in the second half, stopping the Demon Deacons on fourth down on three separate occasions. GT is a couple plays away from being one of the highest-ranked teams in the country. Remember, the Yellow Jackets' two losses have each come in one-point games. 6. Florida State, 2-4, 2-3 Atlantic Coast, another game, another two-interception performance by quarterback James Blackman. The true freshman has now been picked off twice in each of the Seminoles' past three games. But FSU can live with the interceptions. Fourth quarter fumbles? Not so much. With the opportunity to lead his team to a go-ahead touchdown, Blackman faked a handoff to Cam Akers on the zone red, but in doing so, lost control of the ball. Louisville hopped on the ball and rattled off an 8-play, 59-yard game-winning drive. Since the Seminoles' Week 1 loss to number 1 Alabama, every one of their games has been decided by one score. The talent surrounding Blackman is as good as any team in the nation. Knowing FSU, head coach Jimbo Fisher's team could turn it around any time now. That being said, the Seminoles are running out of time. A loss to BC on Friday will drop the Seminoles outside of the top 10.